However, this data is not that strong. The group or the expert group in India and from ICMR actually looked at this data and then did a risk-benefit analysis and felt that this may be useful in people who are healthcare workers managing COVID-19 patients or very close contacts of those patients who are of COVID-19 patients. But it is not a treatment for everyone, and the data is not that strong. Secondly, like any other drug, this drug also has side effects. Therefore, these two categories that were chosen are those who can monitor their side effects. One is doctors, healthcare workers themselves, who are can monitor for side effects. And the close contacts of a positive patients are also being monitored by healthcare workers, so they can be monitored side effects of the drugs. For the general public, taking hydroxychloroquine can be harmful. Especially, it can have cardiac toxicity, leading to irregular heartbeat. And therefore, I would say that everyone does not need to take hydroxychloroquine. It can do more harm than good. It should be taken only for those who it has been recommended for by the guidelines, because that has been taken looking into the risk-benefit analysis. A combination of hydroxychloroquine and azithromycin is a treatment strategy, which was used in the study that I just mentioned in from France and one study from China, which suggested this combination may be useful if we give it to patients with moderate to severe illness. The data is still not that strong to say one way or the other, because the study was done in a small group of patients. But since no other treatment is available, therefore it was felt that we should try this treatment along with other treatments, and number of studies are being done, research trials are being done, looking at multiple treatment regimens, including this, some other drugs which are used for HIV infection. There is a new drug which is being used in the US, which was used for Ebola, remdesivir, and certain other drugs are also being tried. So since this drug is easily available, both azithromycin and hydroxychloroquine are available easily in the Indian market and physicians are comfortable with using it, it is being used as a possible therapy